There she goes! Up, up, and away with a friendly farewell! Off on her journey, blessed by the best! Off to the new world with a salute from the old! And now, here she comes, where the torch of liberty beckons! Beckons her to the land of the free! To the entertainment capital of the world. Through the golden glow of a Tinseltown twilight, down to her Beverly Hills mansion, comes the megastar's megastar. It's Dame Edna Everidge, talk show hostess, guru, and confidant to the rich and famous, now appearing in her own show for the first time on American television. A lady in a hurry, hurrying to bring her gifts of caring and sharing to her guests and audience alike, hurrying to star in her own show in her own home, Dame Edna's Hollywood. Ladies and gentlemen, Dame Edna Everidge.
Oh, it's wonderful to be here in Los Angeles, California. It's breathtaking. I'm so excited. You know, I've done my show, my wonderful show, all over the world, but tonight I'm humbled. Yes, I am humble. Or I would be if I knew how. I would be. And, of course, I have an orchestra in my own front hall. Hello, boys.
Hi.
Aren't I looking gorgeous?
Oh, you look gorgeous, Doc. Oh,
hello, Doc. I hope I'm not overdressed. I can see I'm not. No, but it's lovely, Doc. This job came along in the nick of time for you.
Oh, yes.
Didn't it? Oh, Doc. You were lucky to find work so soon, weren't you?
The boys and I are so grateful, aren't we, guys?
Yes.
Oh, really.
I hope it can be a permanent position, boys. But you've been out in the wilderness too long, Doc, haven't you?
Yes, I have.
Welcome to a real talk show.
And I love your home. It's so beautiful.
Oh, yes, well, I have an orchestra 24 hours a day in my own home. Other people have Walkmans. Being a doctor must help, darling.
No, darling, I'm not a doctor.
Oh, well, you have M.D. after your name, Doc.
No, no, that stands for musical director.
Oh, I thought I had a general practitioner on trumpet. Well, Cossums, my name is Dame Edna Everidge, and for the next hour or so, you'll be with me in my beautiful home in Beverly Hills, meeting wonderful, wonderful guests. Of course, my home is beautiful. It's deceptively spacious. That means it's spacious on the outside, and on the inside, it's even more spacious. It's actually a replica of an old Spanish mission, and it's built on the site of an old Spanish mission. It's identical to the Spanish mission we knocked down to build it, as a matter of fact. But it has modern conveniences, like no monks or nuns. call me old-fashioned, but I don't want celibates wandering around. I don't flagellating themselves as they sometimes do. I wouldn't like it. My guests wouldn't like it, or most of my guests wouldn't like it. There's the odd guest who would, of course. Well, it reminds me, listeners, that, you know, although I'm a widow, I do not ride alone in the stretch limo of life. Ladies and gentlemen, allow me to introduce my constant traveling companion, my New Zealand bridesmaid, Madge Allsop. Come on, Madge. Let America take a look at you. Please. Come on. Don't encourage her. Oh, look at you. Don't encourage her, please. Look at you. What are you wearing? It looks like something out of a window cleaner's bucket, Madge. I bought her a lovely frock, but she's gone out with a Salvation Army charge card. She's come back in that, old Madge. You know, when I was filling in the immigration form, I didn't know how to describe Madge. I didn't know whether to say bridesmaid or significant other. In fact, I put insignificant other. Why I keep her in my entourage, I don't know. Oh, she's familiar. She's a sort of security blanket. Though you wouldn't catch me chewing her corners in bed at night, I can assure you. Well, because tonight I have better things to do, like talking to my guests. And who are they? Well, tonight we have Larry Hagman. Trouble too, haven't you? Not a lot of trouble, but a bit of trouble. Let me drink you in. I'm so excited to see you.
I'm so happy to be here.
You're excited to see me. We excite each other.
Yes, we do.
That's lovely. We can still excite each other.
I brought you this little thing.
Yes,
for
what
your...
is it? It's a bromeliad.
Yeah, it is a bromeliad.
Yes. You know, it's exotic and unusual and decorative, and I hate it. I do. It's nothing personal, darling. It's just that I like gladioli and...
Okay.
Oh, I can't be. These are the runt of Dame Nature's litter. I think, however... You weren't to know that I don't happen to like that particular type of cactus, but don't let it worry you. Look at you. High-fashion, punky look that you've got. You, darling. Of course... I've got plants. I've got a lot of these bromeliads.
Oh,
Robert,
actually,
look, see them everywhere. Robert De Niro, little Jodie Foster, little Julia Roberts. You know, I've been spraying them with defoliants, but they still seem to survive. Madge, the badge, please, the badge. Thank you, darling. Thank you. I'd just like to pop that on you, if I may, Cher. You are. It's only... It's no offence. It's just if I forget your name, I like to have that. People, hard of hearing people watching might not know who you are.
Right.
Well, it's a nice name, Cher. I love it. It's French for costly, I
think. Yes, it is.
Is there an advantage, do you think, in having just a little name like that? Does it help in any way?
Well, you know, signing autographs can be tedious, and you know that, Edna.
Oh, I know.
Probably no one knows more than you do. No one's... I mean, when you're a megastar...
Well, I have to do it a lot, but I have a rubber stamp.
Okay.
I shouldn't have said that.
No. Well, I'm a little more old-fashioned. I do it by hand.
You do?
Yes.
Oh, you care, you see.
I do.
And it doesn't take so long.
Right.
Of course, I was just plain Edna for quite a long time. But then I was given a damehood by the Queen of England. It's a special honour. Just like your own General Schwarzkopf was made Sir... Norman Schwarzkopf, do you remember that?
Yes.
He doesn't use the sir very much. I adore him. I feel a bit sorry for him, having to dress in combat gear all the time, sure. No, he's camouflaged. It's a wonder his wife can find him. You know, she'd be saying, "Oh, Norman, come here, I want to tie your bow tie," and she'd be looking, and he'd be out there in the children's sandbox, wouldn't he? reliving that wonderful conflict. But, you know, we both have ventilated kneecaps, don't
yes, we do.
Well, how can I put it? You're wearing more than you usually do. You have a... No, no, please, I'm sorry. Don't twist my words. You have a reputation for wearing rather flimsy and provocative little numbers, don't you? There's no two ways about that.
That's true, but you know, when I met the Queen and I dressed appropriately and I felt that coming here, I needed to dress appropriately, because after all, there's hardly any royalty in America. I mean, a couple of queens, I guess, here and there, but I wanted to dress appropriately for you.
You have. Yes. You have. And I'm glad you weren't wearing, you know, what is it, a sort of cobweb and two bottle tops.
Yes.
I'm glad. I have a vision of you coming home in a flimsy little item and closing the door and sighing a deep sigh of relief and slipping into something all enveloping. That's what I have a picture of. I love your hair. Can I touch your hair?
Yes. Well, it's not exactly mine, Edna.
It's not organically grown.
No, it's oil, or, you know, it's petroleum, something like
petroleum.
That. It's synthetic.
Oh, is it? But it's very effective.
Thank you. I like it. I like being a redhead.
I adore it.
Thank you.
I've thought of going into wigs, but my own natural hair is so exotic.
It is.
It is. I'm very lucky because I was born this colour.
Yeah.
And you know, for many years I dyed it. I dyed it brown because I hated being different. Kiddies
right.
At school, I was called Mauve Mop when I was at school. But then we get our mother's hair, and in roughly the same places, do you, don't we? We do. Mind you, it came as a bit of a surprise. I mean, I didn't know my hair was going to grow in some of the places it did.
Yes. And that colour would be shocking.
Yes. Well, in this colour, my bikini line might have given people a turn.
Yes.
Mightn't it? Oh, dear, but my mother, well, she wasn't, is a pretty wonderful woman. Are you close to your mother at all?
Well, we're talking this week, actually. We've been talking for the last couple of weeks, just weeks.
Have there been little tensions in your relationship with your mother?
Since I was very little, my mother and I have had a very... what's that word I'm looking for?
Volatile?
Yes, exactly the word I was looking for. We have a very volatile relationship.
Well, it's another form of caring, isn't it? I think it'd be a funny parent that we adored all the time and 24 hours a
right.
day. And my mother, of course, well, I haven't been close to my mother for some time. She's let herself go, I'm afraid. Well, no, she hasn't. She hasn't let herself go. But the maximum security twilight home
yes.
that she's been in has let her go. She's been sort of released out into the community.
Right.
And she just walked out, a bit like
right.
Jack Nicholson out of the cuckoo's nest.
Right.
She, well, they just turned off the power and the electric fence. And out she went. She's been, I think the word in America is she's been mainstreamed.
I see.
And... oh, I'd love to. You know, I'd love to introduce you to my mother, and then perhaps, you know, you could introduce her to me. Because she hasn't the faintest idea who I am. She hasn't. And I think that makes for a better relationship with mothers.
Is she proud of you, though?
No,
she must be extremely proud of you.
She doesn't know who I am. And so she treats me with a courtesy that she normally reserves for total strangers.
Oh.
She's into senile pride. She started up a senile switchboard. Because people phone in, they don't know why, they can't remember. And she picks up the phone and she doesn't know, you know, why she's doing it. She thinks it's her early morning call or something of the kind. And she started up a senile newsletter called Twilight Times. Oh, it's funny. It's, you know, it's got everyone's name wrong under the photographs and the same story on every page. It's exactly like the Los Angeles Times, as a matter of fact. And exactly like it. And it's, well, it's a state-of-the-art paper for senior citizens. It's got stabilizers to stop it shaking. That's beautiful. It's got a very large lost and found section, too. A very large lost section.
Yes.
Enough of my mother. One thing my mother wouldn't have tolerated, and that's tattooing. And I know you've got the odd little engraving on your skin.
I do. I do. Call me old-fashioned. I do.
When did you start embellishing your epidermis?
Do you know, the truth is, when I left Sunny, I got my first tattoo.
You know, I wasn't going to mention Sunny tonight, and I'm not. You have, and it'd be like a talk show interview if I mentioned him, wouldn't it? And this is not. This is two women just sharing a little of themselves. With a few squillion people watching. When you left him, you started doing little things to yourself. No, please. Oh, for heaven's sake. Stop looking for a hidden agenda. What was the first tattoo? What did it say? Was it a heart on fire or a snake?
No, it was a... I think it was a butterfly. It was a long time ago.
Is it somewhere inaccessible?
Well, to most people.
Oh. Well, it was first thing was a butterfly.
Right.
And what's the latest?
Oh, I have a chain on my arm with some little charms on it.
You know, I could have given you a lovely charm bracelet. It would have saved you. It would have saved her a lot of pain, wouldn't it, viewers? Have you any other beauty tips? Are there any things that you would recommend to a woman, you know, who's reaching not the age of 30, as you must be?
Well, Edna, this is going out on
health?
Television.
Oh. Mental health.
Oh, okay.
I mean, look, it's inside, isn't it? You see, I'm going to make a confession to you.
Oh, okay.
I'm getting difficult, Cher, and I need your help. This morning, a waitress gave me a menu upside down, and I had her dismissed. I did, and she rushed from the restaurant crying, and I feel awful about it. I don't know what to do about it. And then I slammed the door on what were my driver's fingers. And I need help. When you are a megastar as I am, and as you are, people are reluctant to give us advice. Sorry, it must be Larry Hagman. Hello? Hello?
Oh, hello. It's me, Edna. Mel.
Mel, I'm sorry.
Can I come in?
I'm sorry. I've nothing today, thank you.
Edna, it's me, Mel.
Oh,
me.
It's the pool cleaner. Oh. Are you the pool cleaner?
No, I'm not the pool cleaner. Man, you're a kidder. Come on, let me in. It's Mel. Mel Gibson.
Mel Gibson? The only Mel Gibson we know is a young, gorgeous, and quite talented and promising superstar.
Well, thank you, but it's me.
It can't be you. You're in black and white, Mel. You never do black and white movies. Just hang on a moment, I'll colorize you. Oh, yes, it is you. But what are you doing talking into my mailbox, Mel?
Well, I've come to say welcome to L.A. Can I come up?
No. I'm sorry, you can't.
Well,
I've got people here.
I could come up and join them.
Well, you could come up and join them, but you won't. You're not going to barge in, is he, darling? It's bad manners. And
well,
what are you going to do if you get
here? I could come up and sit down, and you could ask me some questions, and I could answer them.
Oh, boring.
Well, I can
what can you
I
do?
I can sing, I can tap dance, juggle. I can juggle.
Juggle? What can you juggle?
Well, anything. Chainsaws, fruit.
No, we've no chainsaws here. We don't have any fruit here at the moment, Mel. I'm terribly sorry, darling.
Well, there's a market just down the street. I'll go and get some. I'll be right back.
No, you won't, Mel. No, thank you, darling.
Oh, that's all right.
I don't want performances
some.
Outside my electric gate. Ladies and gentlemen, the gorgeous Mel Gibson! I know you would have liked to have seen little Mel.
It's been a long time. You were a little curt with him, though. I was wondering, I could see that part of your personality kind of...
Well, I get a bit... Well, it's nerves, I suppose, but also, I couldn't have him up here. This woman is hormonally imbalanced.
Oh.
If Mel Gibson came up, it'd tip her over the edge. It would. She'd go ape. She'd go bananas. And Mel's a nice boy. He'd try to oblige her. And this is a family show. I'm sorry, but it is. Call me old-fashioned. But he is lovely, isn't he?
Have you ever thought that maybe this change this kind of nasty side of you? Maybe you have menopause.
Well, it's a big compliment that you should pay me, but that happened some time ago.
Okay.
I passed through it effortlessly, too, I must say. And I think the menopause is very, very overrated.
Usually you're so gracious and I was wondering if maybe something is bothering you.
I don't know. Something that happens, I think, as you become, well, as you climb the ladder to megastardom, as I have. The longer my bank balance gets, the shorter my fuse seems to get. That's how it is. I try to discuss it. Last night when I went to the Megastars Anonymous meeting, and everyone was lovely. You were lovely there. Oh, no, I shouldn't have said it. No. You weren't there. No, you weren't there. I wasn't there. It doesn't exist.
Okay.
However, I have to say that, little Julia Roberts hugged my shoulders. Mickey Rooney hugged my knees. What was he doing there? And please. I meant that caringly. Oh, Michael Jackson, little Sly Stallone, everyone helped me. Madonna whispered something helpful to me. She said, Edna, your problem is you don't love yourself enough. And I try, heaven knows I try. But there are parts of one that one can't love enough, I think. Well, there are little inaccessible bits that we really only get to see when we're in a strange hotel room with a lot of mirrors, I think. I mean, and then you have to be a contortionist, don't you? There's a bit of me I saw once stretching on into infinity. It was a bit that normally stretches a little bit, but not to infinity. However, I found men a disappointment. On the whole, I have to say that. My husband was a disappointment because he passed away.
Norm.
Did we meet before Norm passed away or after? Do you remember?
I think he was still in the prostate hospital.
Yes. Was I happy or sad?
I think you were very happy because it had been April Fool's and you told him you were coming and he got all excited and you never showed up.
Wasn't that gorgeous?
Yes, it was.
He thought he was being discharged.
Yes,
the hospital. Oh, Cher, I wish he could have laughed at that as we have tonight. Have men disappointed you?
On the odd night.
That's very, you see, that's honesty. That is honest self-revelation. And the sort of thing you tell me that you wouldn't necessarily tell, you know, conventional talk show people in studios.
Well, absolutely. But I mean, you and I have a relationship. I couldn't possibly divulge
these
things.
It's beautiful. I think it's honest self-revelation.
And I feel good about talking to you. You're a mature woman. I look up to you. I look forward to, you know,
you're
a hero for me.
Well, thank you. Please, enough of that, my darling. I'm just a person. Prick me and I bleed. But you know, Cher, you like the company of girls. You've got roommates, really, haven't you?
Yes, I do. I have, at the moment that I have no boyfriend. I've been without a boyfriend for about 10 months. And
yes.
No, it's not sad. I feel.
No, I'm
I
not
feel,
sad. I was just thinking of something else.
Oh, okay.
Sorry, I was just trying to love myself a bit more while you were talking.
Now, I think that I find that women's company is very, very stimulating, and I really enjoy being with them. And I do like men in their proper place.
Exactly. Tell me, you call yourself, what, the Golden Girls?
Yes, we do. We get together and we watch the Golden Girls.
Oh, is that in America, the Golden Girls,
yes,
that show?
Yes.
Oh, isn't it scary?
Yes. But you'll never live like that.
Have you seen the final episodes?
No.
In overseas, of course, it's nearly over and it's very, very spooky. Didn't you know?
No.
Have they had the earthquake yet?
No.
Oh, it's ghastly. Look, honestly, it makes the silence of the lambs like Mary Poppins. The new... the fire... And Blanche becomes a serial killer. Haven't you got to that bit?
No, I haven't.
Oh, it's ghastly. It's ghastly.
Please. Edna, dear, you'll have to excuse me. She just had her shampoo.
Oh, lovely. Yeah. Look, excuse me, but you don't mind me saying so, but you have a spooky resemblance to Bea Arthur.
Oh, well, I am Bea Arthur.
Ladies and gentlemen, Bea Arthur! Well, if you're Bea Arthur, what are you doing washing my dog?
Oh, come on now, Edna. You know that I always come by and wash your dog
for you. Oh, I do know that, but our viewers don't. I just said it for their benefit. Silly Billy.
Yeah.
Little, my little Yorkshire Terrier, yes. My little Fergie. That's her name. Oh, hello, Fergie. What have you been doing for Fergie?
Well, she's in fine form. She's just had her aquatherapy in the flotation tank. And she's had a little acupuncture, you know, for that terrible flea problem.
Acupuncture for fleas? Yeah. How Californian.
Right.
Do you know Cher? She's a singer.
B.
This is B. She does a bit of
Edna,
acting.
Edna. Cher and I are old friends.
Oh,
how are you?
I'm lovely.
I have not seen you in so long.
I know.
Have you been on the road?
I have. I was in England, I was in Germany and Spain.
I spoke to your manager at one time.
Right.
I forget what he said. Have you ever played Cleveland?
No, I've actually never played Cleveland.
I love what you're wearing.
Thank you so much.
I love it. I love the whole.
Thank you.
I love the whole bit. But you look fabulous.
Thank you.
Gosh, it's been a long time.
It's been really a long time.
Really,
since we saw each other.
Long time, but it's nice seeing
thank
you.
Thank you. It's
let's
nice
get
you.
Together, first.
All right.
So let's do lunch.
Okay. I'd love it. You know what?
Like
when are you going to start the Golden Girls again?
August 5th again.
And I really.
I'm sorry to interrupt. I'm terribly sorry, but you're going to sing a song for a share. I think it's time you got ready, darling.
All right.
I'm terribly sorry. I'll see you in a moment.
All right.
Off you go.
Edna, dear, we were just.
No. No, please. Please, I'm afraid my home is really only zoned for one talk show at a time, Bea. Still, it's been lovely hearing you chattering away. Don't take offence, darling. It's just I think there's a little bit more work to do on Fergie.
Yeah, she still has to do her primal barking therapy.
Oh, lovely.
Yes.
Well, off you go.
Come along,
ladies
Fergie.
And gentlemen, Bea Arthur! Excuse I, but do you only do dogs?
How do you mean?
I wondered if you could stretch a point.
Gotcha. Come on.
Alone at last. You know, I'm in the mood for a ditty from Cher. That was lovely. I enjoyed that.
Thank you.
Oh, I love that song. I hope that song will be available for purchase.
Will it? Yes, it will.
You're thinking of putting it on the market?
Yes.
It is already.
It is on the market.
It's in a beautiful album. What's the name of the album?
Love Hurts.
Love Hurts, please. What a lovely gift for someone. let this will make. For someone who you love or someone who you wish to hurt, I presume. Or both. At least she smells nicer anyway, Cher. This'll be Larry, Jack. This'll be Larry. Hello, Larry. Larry?
No, it's not Larry, it's Jack.
Jack?
Yes, Jack Palance. Jack Palance.
Jack Palance.
Yes.
Sorry, have you got the right house?
I'm a neighbor. I've come to take Madge to the movies.
Madge to the movies. Oh, I'm sorry, Mr. Palance. She's in a meeting.
Oh, is
and she's having root canal treatment, and she's out.
Oh, my God, is there anything else?
Well, come up, darling, and have a drink anyway. We'd love to see you, wouldn't we? It's neighborly. Come
right.
on, I'll see you in a moment.
Okay.
Bye. The name is familiar. Have you heard of him, Jack Palance?
Oh, yes, he's an actor. Very famous actor.
Famous actor?
How does Madge know him?
That's the mystery to me. Must be when she goes to the supermarket. Doc, have you heard of Jack Palance?
Well, of course. He's been in Attila the Hun and City Slickers. A lot of great movies.
Oh.
And Shane.
Shane?
Yes.
I've heard of that. In that case, I suppose we should give a very big Hollywood welcome to Jack Palance.
Hi.
Lovely to see you. What's
Thank
that
you.
You've brought?
This is what they call a bromeliad. I brought this for your lady friend.
Oh, little Madge, did you?
Yes.
May I take it?
I wish you would.
Thank you so much. Do come up and meet Cher.
All right. Who?
Cher, this is my neighbor, Mr. Palance.
We know each other.
Oh,
yeah. How are you? It's nice
Thank
to see
God.
You.
To have you here.
Yes.
Oh, the badge. I'm sorry. Oh, I don't have a badge to put on you.
That's all right.
Because I didn't expect you would be popping in.
It's all right. I'm getting to like it, not like cops anyways. I don't want a badge. Oh. You know, I think I've got it made for tonight.
Well, I think you might.
His name is Jack, Madge. I don't know why you put the name Vlad on his lapel.
Well, Vlad is only for those people who really know me intimately.
Oh. Is your name Vladimir?
Yes, it is Vladimir. My name is Vladimir Ivanovich Palahniuk.
Is that your original name,
Honest to
Mr.
God,
Palance?
Yeah. What's your original name?
My original name is Sherilyn Sarkeesian.
Oh. It's Armenian?
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh.
I feel as though I'm in a quicksand.
She's going to steal. What is yours?
My name is Edna May Everidge.
Oh, you got to be kidding.
Yes, it is. But you know, Vlad worries me. It reminds me of Vlad the Impaler.
Yes,
I hope you're not
yes,
going to do
yes.
any impaling tonight.
Well, sitting with three lovely women, I'd love to be able to get to do some impaling. What the hell else am I going to do?
Well, we are defenseless. I'm sorry to say that your style will be cramped. Mr. Lawrence Hagman of Malibu is coming in a moment.
All right. I know that you're busy. I know that you're going to be very good. Cher, what are you doing later?
Well, I don't know. Madge had offered to take me out in the town.
She offered me the same thing. We're going to end up in a real threesome situation. It's going to
I
be
can assure you,
delicate.
You won't,
Are
Mr.
You coming
Palance,
too?
If I may call you that. No, I'm not. You'd if be you missing make... nothing taking Madge, if
no,
refraining
no, no.
from taking
no.
Madge
all
out.
All right, all right.
People
all right.
who have taken Madge out come back with a haunted expression on their faces. They come back traumatized because there's something she wants that no normal man feels like giving her. Not even an old cow puncher.
Yeah.
And cattle rustler such as yours.
I understand it.
Excuse me. Hello?
Hello?
Who is it?
Hello,
Nobody.
Edna.
Heavens above. It's Mel. He's come back. Nobody speak. I don't want him to know we're here. Let's pretend to be out. Doc, down. Get the boys down.
Edna, I know you're in there. I bought the oranges.
The oranges?
I'm
going to
juggle. How's that?
Oh.
Well, sounds like you got a lot of people up there.
Well,
they seem to like me.
Yeah, they adore you, Mel. They adore you, darling. But I'm not sure juggling with oranges is well primetime television. I'm sorry.
Yeah, you're right. I bought some cucumbers.
No, Mel, no. I don't want juggling.
I can stand on my hands.
That's
How's that?
That's what I'm after. Mel, I'm... Please, all I can see is your feet. They're not your best feature, Mel. Go home, Mel. Home.
I don't want to go home. I can wiggle my ears.
We can all wiggle our ears. This is America.
Well, I've got friends out in the car. I've got Frank Sinatra and Jack Nicholson here.
This is a private home, I'm afraid, not a nightclub or a casino. No, you don't need to hang on to other people's coattails, Mel. They're your friends, not mine, but bring them round tomorrow for a swim in the pool. You can, that's if Esther's not using it. Bye. Goodbye, darling. Bye. Goodbye. Bye. Mel Gibson!
You know, I want to ask one little question. Will you come out with me?
I'm a happily widowed woman, as a matter of fact, Mr. Palance.
You've been happy since you were widowed, yeah?
Well, it's an awful thing to say, isn't
what is it?
But I felt a sense of relief.
Have you? Since he died?
My husband, no, I have to tell you, my husband was one of the world's most famous prostate sufferers. He was the first recipient of a prostate transplant. The doctors said there was a big chance that his organ could be rejected. And I said to them, well, he ought to be pretty used to that by now. Excuse me. Hello, this is my security. It's Jesus with a J. Hello, Jesus. Oh, how thrilling. Mr. Hagman is here. Ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, and resentment aside, he's been very, very late tonight. The delightful, ebullient, and very unpunctual Lawrence Hagman! Stamens with him. I'm going to have to resort to my technology. I'm sorry, I had to terminate him. However, it's good riddance. Don't worry, I've got paramedics in the basement. Soon Larry Hagman will be relatively normal and able to lead a comparatively normal life.
Yes, I know.
Meanwhile, more after this little break. Poor Mr. Palance. I feel a bit sorry for him, but I had to phone his wife. You know, it nearly broke her heart to hear that he'd been round here pestering my bridesmaid. But he's adorable, really. Isn't he lovely having him for a neighbour? I remember now... he'll be round here borrowing cups of things. Now, when Norm was in intensive care, that's my late husband, he used to watch old Jack Palance's films. And I remember he once said of Jack's face, he said, well, he didn't get a face like that from eating strawberries. That was typical of my husband's humour. Well, where were we, Cher? Before we were interrupted.
Well, what did you do to Larry Hagman?
I don't know. He's so unpunctual. Oh, no, I dropped him, didn't I?
Yes!
I terminated him. Oh, I feel awful about that now. I wonder where he is. What's that splashing noise? Oh, look!
It all went black. I woke up and I thought it was a remake of Sunset Boulevard.
That's closer to the truth than you know. It is. Eat your heart out, Gloria Swanson. Larry, look, please. Do you know who you are? Dallas. J.R.
Gloria. Gloria Swanson. You are Gloria Swanson.
No, his mind is gone. But this will help him make a clean start, I suppose. Oh, look what you're doing to Madge, for heaven's sake. Look, you're dripping wet. Get out of there, Madge, quickly.
So sorry.
There we are. No. Take that with you. And throw it away.
Madge, really.
Put it down the waste disposal, for heaven's sake.
Oh, look at it. Terribly sorry.
You sit on her chair, it's damp already. Larry, look, Is anything coming back to you at all? I mean...
Yeah.
I am Dame Edna.
Oh, yes, of course, yes. I'm a great admirer of Dame
Edna.
Yes,
you're here to be interviewed.
Am I?
You are. How did you begin your career? When did it start?
Could I perhaps get into something a little more comfortable?
Oh, of course.
Yes, right.
And after that, you can tell us what your favorite episode of I Dream of Jeannie was. Can't you go? I've got a nice brunch coat out there. It's Larry Hagman! Thank heaven for a professional. However, no. I've been dripping all over the place. Where were we? You know, Larry and I make music together as personalities, and in a way, well, in a very special way, we do too, don't we, Cher? I feel a duet coming on.
Oh, Volgende week zaterdag kunt u om dezelfde tijd, dus direct na de Flying Doctors, kijken naar deel 2 van Dame Edna verovert Hollywood. En de gasten zijn dan onder andere Blanche, ook van de Golden Girls, Ringo Starr, Kim Basinger en Robin Williams. Dus het vervolg van Dame Edna in Hollywood volgende week na de Flying Doctors bij de VARA op Nederland 2.